didn't hear you.
Ibopoenu! Ibopoenu!
Squad down, squad down.
Shout the name, shout the name! Biafra! Shout the name, shout the name!
Biafra!
Shout the name, shout the name!
Biafra!
Listen, audience.
Freedom that you have fought for, that you have suffered for, that you have dreamt of, and that you stand for. Nnamdi Kanu is my friend, and he will always be my friend. What his hip-hop family have done to me, for my family, by honoring us today, by coming to my mother-in-law's burial, is something that we will never forget. You have stood with us on our day of mourning. You have stood with us in our time of trial and difficulty. God will stand with you. We appreciate you. We love you. I'm here to say thank you and to encourage you. I also wish to say this. There are many people from outside the Eastern Zone that are not even of Igbo extraction, but they appreciate you also. They are praying for you. Because what you are saying is what many of them are thinking and dreaming but cannot say.
Yes.
You have proved yourself to be true Igbo men.
Yes.
Unintimidated, irrepressible, unstoppable. And why am I not surprised? Because that is what Nnamdi is.
Yes.
One of the greatest leaders that this nation has ever seen. One of the greatest and strongest men that the Igbo race has ever been blessed with. And I say this loud and clear. No matter what they've done to him, no matter where he is, no matter what they say, no matter what they do, because God raised him and kept him, Nnamdi Kanu can never die. You may not even know it. There are millions in the Southwest that will hear of this. But you, as proud sons of the East, that have stood up to say no more tyranny, no more hegemony, no more suppression, you have stood with the son of the West on his day of mourning. We will never forget that. And I appeal to you to please continue in peace. You've been restrained. Be restrained. Because our struggle is not one of bloodshed, unlike the Fulani herdsmen. Our struggle collectively as settlers, as middle belters, and as Igbo men and women is one of peace, righteousness, and truth. As long as we hold on to those ideals, and as long as we continue to remember and to honor our leader and my friend and brother, Nnamdi Kanu, we can never go wrong. I will end by saying this. The leaders of the East, your fathers, your governors, your senators, and each and every one of them, even Your Highness, all of them, I have to tell you, that they have been so good to us. They have been good to us. Never ever mistake their silence in times of provocation for any form of weakness. But the truth is this, you are their strength. You are our strength. Together, if we stand with them under the leadership of Nnamdi, and we stand with the rest of us in this nation, I will tell you this, that every oppressed man and woman in this union called Nigeria, every marginalized man and woman in this union called Nigeria, every individual who has had his family slaughtered by either Boko Haram jihadist terrorists or by Fulani herdsmen that drink blood and live by ink and take out human parts and destroy all that is not theirs. If we stand together as one, we fight for each other's ideals and each other's dreams. They may not be identical, but if you stand and we stand behind you, when our time comes and we stand, you will stand behind us.
Yes.
We stand with you.
Yes. We have already stand with you.
Aspire and dream and believe. And let no man threaten you, whether it be death, incarceration, whatever it is. You cannot kill an idea whose time has come. Yes. God be with you.
Also with you.
God bless you. God bless you. And may God scatter our collective enemies.
Yes.